Hey everyone, it's Derek here with another video, and today we're talking about AirPods Pro. Let's start off with the specs. The AirPods Pro start out at $250 retail. Over the holidays, it basically had a $20 off, so you got them for $230. Now, what we're gonna determine is, are these worth $250? The AirPods Pro make it really easy to sync up with your iPhone specifically just by opening it next to an iPhone, and it opens up a screen that allows you to see and sync to them. So basically when you open it up, you can see battery life for the actual AirPod, so the individual AirPod, so like the left one and the right one. You can also see the charge with the actual case as well. So in total, you get about 24 hours of total charge time. So you get up to 5 hours of charge with the single charge here with the AirPods. And then you get to recharge it up just by putting it back into the actual case. And it'll charge it back up to 24 hours. And that's with perfect conditions. So that's with noise canceling off and with transparency mode off. So basically all the features that these particularly come with, those particular features being off. Additionally, it has a quick charge feature, so if you put these back in here and they're dead and there's zero charge left and you put them back in here, 5 minutes of charge will get you 1 hour of actual listening time. And also that's with the caveat of if it's completely dead, batteries being charged up, and also if you're not listening with any of those modes on, so transparency mode and noise canceling. So let's talk about more features of these particular AirPods and why they're specifically $250. Now, with these, they have a nice, they have a sort of different design, and Apple just keeps throwing Pro at the name just to sort of aim for like a more expensive experience. But basically these have three different microphones here, three different sensors here. One on the bottom is specifically for the microphone to actually listen to what you're saying and to see how, like, to do like Hey Siri and stuff like that. Also have that transparency mode, which is really nice. So if you're running outside and you want to hear what's going on around you, or if you're in the office listening to music, it's actually a pretty decent in practice. I've tried this while running, and I've tried this also in the office, taking work calls and different things like that. It works decently well. I don't really have any complaints about transparency mode or even noise canceling mode. It's actually pretty nice from a standpoint of when you put it into your ear, there's not a lot of pressure. When you actually have it suctioned in your ear, it doesn't feel like it takes out the air from you. So right now I'm in transparency mode and I can basically hear an amplified sound. So like if I'm hitting the desk over here, I can actually hear it loud and clear. Now if I touch this and hold it, it'll put it into noise canceling mode, but you don't get that suction feel that you get with a lot of over the head headphones. And this is also bringing into one of the features of the AirPods Pro, which is something that's nice where you're not really just tapping into your ear canal. It's what Apple calls force touch. So basically what you do is on your ear here, you hold this in and then you put some pressure on it, and you can hear in your ear when it switches the mode with a little chime. And then now all of a sudden I can hear all the things around me instead of it canceling out the noise. Now, with this here as well, this is essentially a microphone that it's using to amplify the sounds that are coming in around you. One touch for play and pause, and then two taps to skip, and then three taps to go backwards. Additionally, a long press will invoke a switch of the actual noise cancellation to transparency off or noise canceling. In the actual app, you can change it from by default, it changes it from noise canceling to transparency mode, but you can change it and set it for all three of the settings. So you can do transparency off and noise canceling. Let's talk about sort of the fit and comfort. I did the ear fitting or the seal test, whatever they want to call it, and it's just okay. I don't really think that it actually does a lot. You can sort of tell better yourself if the actual ear tip fitting works for you or not. What I found out was that these are very, very comfortable. Probably the most comfortable earbuds that I've ever tried, which is really awesome that they finally made a product that stays in your ears, which it does. These things don't come out, at least of my ears. I know it really just depends on your ear fit. My impressions of them are really good. And the modes that are being used, whether you're doing off transparency mode or what have you, work really well. I haven't gone on a flight with these, so I don't know how well they cancel noise from that perspective. But right now, air vents blowing in the house, I'm just going to switch it to noise canceling. And it does a pretty decent job. I can still hear it, but it cancels all of the noises around me, which is really nice from a standpoint of, you know, just being an earbud versus like a complete seal around your head. The other thing is that these are also more comfortable than the AirPods or the AirPods 2 or whatever you want to call it. It also comes with a wireless charger, which is nice to have from a standpoint of is if you have a pad and you can just plop it on there and it'll charge right up. Let's also talk about call quality.
Hey, this is the phone call test on the AirPods Pro. It should be isolating the wind from my voice. Right now we're heading into a headwind, so we should hear a little bit of background noise, but it should cancel most of it out. Let me know in the comments what you think about this audio.
I made a call to my buddy Andy and basically was trying to test out and see what it actually sounded like from a standpoint of receiving calls. And it's from what I hear and from this sound clip, it sounds pretty good. It's much less muffled than the Powerbeats Pro. And it's actually what he said was it sounds actually a little bit better than actually talking through the phone. So the issue was that it wasn't nearly as clear. So I have a few different devices. I have the Powerbeats Pro and I also have the Jabra Steel, which is specifically meant for Bluetooth calls. And it's not as clear as the Jabra Steel, but it's pretty good on par. And it blocks out sound pretty well from a standpoint of wind noise and different things like that. So I did a few tests from a standpoint of, hey, this is what you're doing when you're you know, running, this is what it sounds like when you're running, this is what it sounds like when you're driving in a car, and this is also sounds what it sounds like just making an office call. Also, something that's nice is that, you know, Apple will actually sell you these, whether they're medium, small, or large, on their website for, I believe, $4. So it's nice that Apple's not going to charge like an arm and a leg for it, not to say that $4 is really cheap. Another thing that I kind of liked is that there's a setting to actually read out your messages. So if you get text messages or what have you, you can have it automatically read out text messages. So if you're working or something like that, and your wife calls you or a friend calls you or texts you or what have you, it actually read it out. Now, if somebody sends you a GIF or something like that, it won't read that out. It'll just say, you know, Andy sends a image or something like that. Let's talk about sort of the cons about this. So first thing is that the price, they're really expensive. Now, Sony also has a pair of noise canceling headphones or noise canceling earbuds, which also cost $250. I haven't tried those out yet, but I've seen a lot of reviews, talked about audio quality is very good in those. Audio quality is not the greatest in these. It's certainly not bad. I've tried them alongside with the Powerbeats Pro, and honestly, I couldn't tell much of a difference. Obviously, these particularly don't stray away from like how the old AirPods were, which essentially was sort of a flat, ish sound signature, which, not very bassy, just flat across the board from a sound, from the standpoint of sound. There is no volume button. That's another con. Like, you still have to invoke Siri for that, which is super annoying, or you have to have your phone in your hand, which, in my opinion, is not the greatest experience. Now, with thinking about what you would connect with on a run, different things like that, I would assume that you would have Apple Watch and you would change the volume on that. If you don't have that and, that's not enough battery for you, then I guess you would have your phone and it would be easy just to click it, or it would be somewhat easy to just invoke Siri. But I've actually tried it while running and it works pretty well. The other thing is that it comes with a Lightning to USB-C charger. It doesn't come with a brick of any kind, so you would need to use your own, or you would need to have a USB-C port to plug it into, which is kind of weird. Or you can use your old accessories from a standpoint of having a Lightning cable, which, if you have an iPhone, would be fine. The one thing that I would say is that if you're running and you wear a hat, it doesn't work that well, especially if you're in transparency mode, because these microphones, if anything rubs up against them, it sounds really loud in your ear. So it's better to have either noise canceling on, or you can have noise canceling off and just have it regularly set on. And you'll get a little bit more battery life that way too. And the other thing is that I also tried to pair this with my PC, and I was getting issues actually trying to make calls and different things like that. It wouldn't stay the microphone as well as the headset, so listening as well, at the same time. It would choose one and then only work as the other. So if I was making a Skype call or something like that, or on Microsoft Teams and trying to make a call or trying to accept a call, people would only be able to hear me, but I would not be able to hear them. So there's a bug with Apple devices when it comes to connecting to a PC. So you should be made very aware of that. Overall, there's really nothing too terrible that I can say about these, other than the fact that they cost a lot. And if you're not immersed in that Apple ecosystem, then I would say it's not the greatest option for you. But if you are, it certainly is, and I couldn't recommend this thing enough. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments, and yeah, let me know what you think. I think there's going to be a lot of people that buy this. I'm pretty positive during the holidays that these were sold out everywhere, and you basically couldn't get them in a decent amount of time. Other than that, we'll see you in the next video.